Welcome to my kitchen. Today I am going to be making a pizza casserole. I don't know if anybody eats any more pizza than my family. So let's get started. First, I'm going to take a small onion and I'm going to cut it up. We're going to have a pound and a half of hamburger. We're going to have half a pound of pepperoni, a can of tomato soup, a can of cheddar cheese soup. We're going to have 4 cups of noodles. We're going to have a pepper, a small onion, and some cheddar cheese. And that's about it. Oh, we're going to have some oregano. I knew there was something else. So let's get started. I've got my hamburger frying over there, and I'm getting my onion cut up. I had an onion that was just I don't know if I need it all. Oh well, I'm going to save a little bit for my next dish, I think. So, anyway, before we go any further, I want to get this in the pan and get it going, but I did want to tell you about the Marching In with Casseroles collaboration. You know we have that every March. Greg does a Marching In with Casseroles collaboration. And boy, is it good this year so far. We have got 16 channels. And oh, I've got some good casserole dishes from there. I love my casseroles, as you know. And I'm making me a casserole cookbook out of them. I've been doing that every time I get a casserole off the channels. I print them off and make me put it in my casserole cookbook. And I understand that there are a few channels that's doing that. So you might want to do that. Now I'm putting my hamburger in here. I'm putting my onion in here with my hamburger to saute it a little bit so I can tell you about our channel and what's going on. We've had quite a few really good casserole dishes, but I wanted to let you know that I want you to go to every channel and watch them. Make a comment, because Greg's going to be giving away some wonderful gifts. It is called the Kitchen Collection. He's going to be giving away some cooking casseroles, 2 different sets, and boy could I use those. I think we all can, because you know when it comes time to start making our dishes for the holidays and stuff, I'm out of casserole dishes. What am I going to do? Well, for this, he's giving away 2 different sets. And that would be wonderful, because you're going to have 7 casserole dishes. Wow. And that is wonderful. And then he's going to be giving away a food processor that we could all use, especially right now to getting ready with our gardens to cut all this stuff up with. We could do that real easy. And a food carrier. He gave away 1 year a food carrier. And this year he's giving away a food carrier, but it's 2. It goes for 2 carriers. So that's going to be wonderful. And I know you all are going to love it, and you're going to want to get it. And it's so easy to do. All you have to do is, same thing you always do, is go watch the channels, and you're already doing that. Make a comment at each channel on the casserole dish. And at the end, Greg will be choosing one of the dishes that you commented on, and he will be drawing, and that person is going to win not one of those items, but all 5 items. Oh my goodness, that's going to be wonderful. I know I tried out one of the dishes the other night, and I'm like, oh, that was so good. But I like making the cookbook. So we've done this now for 4 years. So if I keep up with it, I'm going to have a nice cookbook. I know some of the channels are doing that also. Other people are. And then some of our friends that watch us are also doing that, which is nice because they're going to have all the recipes. Sometimes it's easier to pick up a book and look up the recipe than it is to have to run through everything trying to find it. At least I know it while I get everything else ready. I know Greg took me for a walk through the woods today. He called and he was out in the woods walking around. He loves to walk around in the woods. And he was showing me all the flowers, different flowers that had come up. And it was really neat. It was neat because I felt like I was there because he was telling me all of them and talking to me about them. And it was just really fun. So now I need about 1/2 pound of pepperoni. So I'm going to put some in there. Well, we buy pepperoni by a lot at a time because we make pizzas quite often. My husband's a good pizza maker. Get this in there. Greg's got his peas are up about 1/2 inch. I was really surprised. But he's down there in Tennessee, so I guess the weather's a lot different down there than it is here. So now I'm not measuring this. I'm just putting it in, as you can see, but you're supposed to have 1/2 cup. And this is cut pretty thin. My husband bought it for pizzas. Stir in my tomato soup. Guess I'll I think the last time I bought tomato soup, I paid 69 cents for it. Not this time. I think this time I paid $1.29 for it. And my cheddar cheese. You're supposed to put in a can of milk. So I'm going to put in a can of milk. There you go. I was laughing the other day at Greg because he was making a casserole and I kept saying, he's not going to get all that stuff in there. He's not. It was his cabbage casserole. And I think it was. He got it all in there. But I'm thinking, okay, am I going to get mine all in there now? I guess I should have got a bigger pan too. Oh, that smells so good. Oh my goodness. Okay. Smells better than it looks. Then I'm going to put my noodles right in there. I usually put just a little bit of oil in my noodles so that they don't stick together, and I didn't do that this time, but they didn't stick together too bad. I'm gonna gonna taste that for I know what I forgot. Forgot my oregano. Tasted it and I knew right then what I had forgotten. Have you ever done that, making something and you think you got it all okay and you taste it and it's like, I forget. Well, I knew what I had forgot. Okay. Now, a lot of people will put it in and put all their ingredients in and then put their noodles on top. And I like my noodles mixed in a little bit, so I don't do that. I put my noodles in and mix them up a little bit. Not a lot. There's more noodles on top than anything else, but I do it that way. It's supposed to be nice all next week. I am so happy because my husband got a new lawnmower, and neighbors are going to think we're crazy out there mowing. It ain't time to mow, but I think we mow when our yard needs mowed. And my husband wasn't well last winter when it was time to rake leaves, and we didn't get our yard raked because I'd had surgery on my foot. I had a bone taken out, and I couldn't rake leaves. I think I could have, but he wouldn't let me. Two grandsons that live have to go past my house all the time, and they would have seen me. And I think I'd have gotten in trouble doing the front yard. Backyard, I guess I could have done. So I just didn't do it. Now I'm putting my cheese on top, and that's up to you how much you use. And you know, you use less cheese too when you shred it yourself. Melts faster, tastes better, I think. Anyway, so I got out there and raked the front the other day because it was beautiful outside and everybody was at work, so I knew it wouldn't get caught. Now I'm going to put this in the oven for 20, 30 minutes maybe, and then I'll be back. Okay, I'm back and it is out of the oven and it looks wonderful as always. Now we get to taste it. And I hope you will go to all the channels and check them. Make a comment. So that will make you eligible for the kitchen set. Oh, that looks so good. So good. Oh my goodness, that looks so yummy. Got your pepperoni and your hamburger, your noodles. Got your crust is your noodles. And you got your sauce. Oh my goodness, it looks so yummy. We're gonna see if we can't taste this now, maybe. I don't know. But Oh, that is good. But oh my goodness, that is so good. And you saw me make it. It's one of the easiest dishes to make. And it's something your kids are going to love. Because they love pizza. They love the hamburger. They love the pepperoni. Tell them it's just pepperoni in a bowl. I know that is really a good dish. I'll see you in the next class. Thank you, bunches.